Oh no! Not another horror game! And not another video.
In my heart and mind, I always return to Atlantic Island Park.
Where's Mr. Bear?
I haven't seen Mr. Bear, Callum. Stay in the car. I'll go and ask information.
What the hell? Hello, child. Hi, don't talk.
Attention, patrons. The park is now closed. Please make your way to the car park if it is convenient. Employees, prepare the park for shutdown.
What? Son, let you go through the gate. Son? Son, are you in the car? Damn it! Can you just bloody wait for me, child?
Where are you going? Where are you going?
Over here!
Wait up there for Mommy, Callum.
There's something special about the entrance to an amusement park. A line drawn between the real world and the world of whimsy within. On this side, the apathy of our everyday lives. On the other, anything we might dare to dream. It's no wonder Callum ran back inside. I wouldn't want to leave either.
Attention employees, the park is now closed.
Wait for Mommy, Callum.
Home.
Come on, Mommy!
Callum, I told you to wait in the car.
This way, Mommy.
What the hell?
Callum, I told you to wait in the car.
Oh, no. Why is it dark now?
Wait for Mommy, Callum.
Yeah, wait for Mommy. It's a nice place.
Okay. Oh God. Park. What happened here? It's easy to get lost here. Callum!
I can see you right here. Come back. Get in, you little...
Wait, Callum!
Hey, come back, you little weirdo. Bye-bye. Psych, that's the wrong number. Oh. Come back, you little shit. Oh no, it's
Cinderella. Don't hide from me, Callum. I think this belongs to Callum.
I leave their bloody shit on the floor.
She has a chipmunk, huh? Just as a drunk guy in the suit.
Chad, their chipmunk, the worst in class. Can't even seem to pass. Chad gets angry, likes to fight. Chad is beaten every night. Chad will have a dead end job. Chad will die a useless slug. Callum, you want the girl's toilets? You're looking up some little girl skirts, are you? I want to get on the docky. Shut up! I want to get on the dock. Let me on. I want to get on. No, don't leave without me. Yes, I can ride it! I can ride it! Yay!
Come out, sweetie!
This is so fun.
Hello?
Hello?
Near a great forest, there lived a poor woodcutter, his wife and his two children. A boy named Hansel and a girl named Gretel. They were very poor and had very little to bite or sup.
Sup.
What will become of us? The woodcutter asked his wife one night. I tell you what, husband, we will take the children into the thickest part of the forest tomorrow and abandon them there. No, my wife, I cannot do that, said the man. Then we will all four starve, you fool. Hansel and Gretel overheard their parents talking, and Gretel began to weep. Do not fret, Gretel, Hansel said. He crept into her hut and gathered white stones from the ground to fill his pockets. The next morning, the woodcutter leads the children into the forest. Before they leave, their mother gives them a slice of bread and warns them that they will get no more food that day.
Oh no.
Clever Hansel leaves a trail of white stones behind them as they pass into the woods. When their father leaves them, the children wait a while, then follow the trail back to their parents' house. After receiving a thorough scolding from their parents for getting lost in the woods, the children are sent to bed without any supper. Hansel tried to sneak out and collect more white stones, but found that the door was locked. Tomorrow I will take them into the woods myself, the wife told the woodcutter.
No.
In the morning, their mother gave them a slice of bread and led them deep into the forest once again.
What the hell?
Hansel broke his bread into pieces and left a trail of breadcrumbs to lead them safely home. But hungry-eyed birds snatched up the breadcrumbs and his trail was destroyed.
Oh, no.
Abandoned by their parents and unable to find the trail home, the children wandered in the forest for 3 days.
3 days? Without any food? Are you dumb?
The children stumbled into a clearing with an exceedingly strange house. Its walls were made of gingerbread, and its windows were panes of clear sugar. Hansel,
sugar,
desperately hungry, ran forward and began to nibble on the walls.
Nibble, nibble, little mouse. My house!
An old woman emerged from the house, sniffing the air and peering around with cloudy eyes.
Oh, you dear children, who brought you here? Just come in and stay with me. No harm will come.
She's a paedophile.
But Hansel and Gretel stayed back, for the old woman reminded them of their cruel mother.
Come, children, don't be afraid. I have something for you.
The old woman offered them 2 enormous lollipops. The children took them and began to eat.
They got roofies in them.
You see,
nothing to fear here. Come inside, the old woman urged, and the children, still licking their sweets, followed.
Oh, Jesus.
Once inside the house, the old woman changed. She stuffed Hansel into a cage and put Gretel to work, sweeping and cleaning her hut. Your brother will make a good mouthful, the old witch told Gretel. Once he is fattened up, I shall feast upon him.
Oh no, don't do it.
Time passed, and poor Hansel refused to eat, fearing the day that the witch would eat him. The witch, for her part, grew impatient. Today, I will cook and eat your brother, Gretel. Climb inside and light the oven. But Gretel pretended not to understand. I do not know how. Where is the opening? The old witch said, the opening is here. And she moved to show Gretel. Seizing her courage, brave Gretel gave the witch a shove. And the old crone tumbled forward into the oven.
Lul.
Gretel slid a large oven bolt on the door to the oven. Gretel freed her brother Hansel, and together they lit a fire beneath the oven. And though she screamed and begged, the children sat by the oven until her screams had stilled, and the witch was cooked.
Yeah, she did. She did.
Because even children can't survive on sweets, they divided up the body of the old witch and ate her.
Oh my days. Jesus Christ. I don't think it was going to turn into that story. What the hell? Turn your head. Good ducky. I want to get off now. Yay, I'm off. Oh, that took bloody ages.
Hansel and Gretel. I used to read it to Callum when the electricity was shut off. Those poor children. The whole world against them. The forest, the birds, the old witch, even their own parents. I used to imagine that Callum and I were the kids in that story. Not mother and son, but brother and sister. Hand in hand against the unkind world. We were always hungry, looking for our own house made of candy. Looking for the sweetness that could take the pain away. Hunger leads people to desperate, terrible places. Where the tree branches reach like claws.
Okay.
Callum, tell Mommy where you are. Don't hide from me, Callum!
Another accident. This place.
Teddy bear. Who did this to you? I'm bloody out of it. I like that ride.
This old thing used to make the blood run to my head. It can make me dizzy.
The guy just
snapped. Those poor kids.
Quick. I'm getting on the line, I'm getting on the line. I want to get on it.
I can't get on while it's moving.
Let me on! Yeah, I'm gonna go riding in the car. Yay! I'm flying! What the hell? Who bloody hell are you? Some ugly ass face. No, don't stop. Go faster. Go faster, goddammit.
It's shattered. As soon as they fell in pieces, one treacherous thought became a new foundation. All of the love that we shared, all of the warmth and goodness that followed, built on a single traitorous thought.
Stop! Kill him!
What the fuck is that? I'm out.
Come back.
Constant crashes in 80s music. It's gonna support someone's boat.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I've totally got bump carts. Can I fly? Oh, that one's moved. That one is on. I want to drive it. Oh no. Oh, that was so close. Hell no, I'm out. Fuck that shit, I'm out.
It's a matter of public record that I am a failure as a mother. Once, when Callum was very small, I left him asleep in the car while I ran around. I don't even remember where it was. When I came back, the sheriff was standing next to the car, watching my boy through the window. And like what I saw in his eyes. Judgment. He wrote me the ticket without saying a word. Just a scratch of his pen on the notepad. And he gave it to me. My eyes met.
I know what you're going through. My daughter, Helen, she just gets some help.
Help was a bolt of lightning. Help was a thousand volts surging through my veins. Help is agony. I'd rather die. I wanted to scream. I'd rather you pulled your gun and shot me. But instead my mouth said, yes, Sheriff.
Okay. Some suicidal woman over here. Stop on, jump on. That's not really safe. Yay!
Before Mom ran off, after that he mostly just drank. Things were different for Don and I. When we met, I was sweeping the floor at Susie's diner. He came in with some workers, but he didn't try to flirt or copy feel like the others. He just ordered a coffee and sat there, watching me. When my shift was over, he offered to walk me home. I don't know how to describe that walk. We talked and laughed and eventually kissed. It felt like love. It felt like a fairy tale. I can't tell you if Calum was made that night or one of the ones that followed. I think it has to be that night. That one perfect night. Don and I moved in together, but then, well, he died. According to the supervisor, his safety harness failed when he was working on the top of the Ferris wheel. Don was there one moment, and then gone. Sometimes people leave your life for no reason. I was 3 months pregnant with Calum. Fairy tale fucking over.
Okay. This isn't a horror game, it's not scary. Hello there. It's not scary, is it? Callum. Where are you, Callum? Oh, cool. What the hell? Hello? What the hell? Okay.
Their children. You hear them talking about their kids and just the way they talk, their fucking voices make me want to vomit. My angel likes to read, and little Johnny is so good on the piano. Fuck those people! You give up 9 months of your life, Karen, you traumatize yourself giving birth to them, and then you spend the rest of your life as their slave. Fuck right. I just abandoned him.
Jesus Christ.
Where are you, Calum? I always wanted to ride this one. I've never got to ride it before.
I'm rewarded. Yeah, 100 to 1. Yay!
Hello.
What do you want?
Huh?
What do you mean? What have you done to him? Where is Callum? Tell me where my son is.
No.
I'm just been flopping around.
Oh,
an axe. I don't even seem to take that.
Has scared him into silence. Doesn't dare talk. He's usually changing too. Something sinister lurks in the darkness behind his eyes. I catch him staring at me at odd moments. In the night, he tosses and turns, cries out words that I can't understand. When I try to tend him, he snaps and bites his fingers. I think he wants to talk to me. I think he wants to tell me. They are watching him every minute of every day. They are whispering to him in his sleep, changing him. They are taking my baby away from me. I can save him, and there will be pain. But I love him, and in the end, he will understand why. The whole town was shocked by that one. Never found out who did it.
Right there. Oh, boobies.
No, I'm a mermaid. I got the boobies.
Of course. These are mine.
Boobies. 1980s. Your mother looks if. Oh, okay. Wait. What's this? Pop. That's cool.
Don't touch me.
You what? Come at me, you rat. Oh no.
Is a collage of contradictions all of its own. Millions of people die every year in car crashes, and the park has little cars designed specifically to simulate that action. Hear the children scream with joy. In the sideshow alley, you can walk away with 15 cents worth of mass-produced Chinese teddy bears while a grinning carny pockets your hard-earned $5. What secrets lie beneath the summer waters of the lake? The tears of jilted lovers, the soiled condoms of illicit affairs, the clotted blood of the Roman suicide. In the face of the witch, I rolled over it all. I always despised her toothy grin and warning nose. I hate that sparkle in her weathered, watchful eyes. I think Callan is waiting for me. Inside.
Okay.